Hello everyone, today I welcome you all to my another video session wherein I will be explaining you how to use the retry logic mechanism in order to log into any of the web application using automation anyway. So before we start our session for the day, I request everyone of all the latest updates and notifications that we keep posting on our YouTube channel. So let us start our discussion without any further delay. So let us start our session for the day without any further delay. So first of all, you have to go to your automation anywhere and log in with your bot creator credentials. So once you log in with your bot creator credentials, the next step that needs to be performed is to click on the automation tab from the home page. So once you click on the automation tab, the next step that needs to be performed is to click on create a task bot option. So once you click on the create task bot option, a small dialog box will appear wherein you have to give the name to your task bot. So I will be giving the name to my task bot as SRM underscore login, and then I will click on create and edit button. So once you click on create and edit button, the workspace area will be opened where you need to drag and drop your step of actions which you need to build or which you want to build in order to create your automation. So the first step that we need to do is to drag and drop the loop action. So from the loop package, drag and drop the loop action, and in the property section, define the number of times that you want to run your loop. So in this case, we will be running the loop 3 times and will create a variable that is int increment counter. And then click on create and select. So using this, you can create your output variable. So the next step of action that needs to be performed is to drag and drop the open action from the browser package. So from the browser package, drag and drop the open action. So over here, you need to select or define the browser in which you want to open your URL. So over here, I am selecting as Microsoft Edge, and the link to open is fportal.bpglobal.com. And the timeout that we want to give is, we will keep the same timeout, that is 240 seconds. After 240 seconds, this URL will throw, or this set of command will throw an exception. So the next step that we need to perform is to wait for the window to open. So in order to wait for the window to open, from the wait package, you need to drag and drop the wait for window action. So drag and drop the wait for window action, and then in the properties section, select the application for which you want to wait for it to open. So first of all, you have to click on the refresh window. And over here, select the window title, that is BP branded portal. So from here, after BP branded portal, from hyphen till the last, we will select that part, and instead of that, we will replace that part with wildcard character. And we will define the amount of time that we would like to wait for this condition to become true. So in this case, we will give the time as 15 seconds. So now the next thing that we need to do is, once the window is opened and once the window is available, we will use the recorder capture action. So drag and drop the capture action from the recorder package, and select in the properties section, select the window which you want to work with. So I will be selecting this BP branded portal, and then I will scroll down and then click on the capture object. So once you click on capture object, you need to select the area which you want to capture. So in this case, we have to select the text box for the email where we will be entering our user ID. So once you click on this, so once the area is captured, then the action that you want to take on the object is to use the set text option. And over here, my user ID is stored in the credential vault. So I will be using the select a credential option, and then the first step, which will be already by default selected of credential. So I will click on this pick button, and then over here I will select my locker name, which is in this case is shopping cart. And I will select the credential name also, which is also shopping underscore cart, and then I will select the attribute. So in this case I will be selecting the attribute as SRM non-Indonesia username. And then over here I will be storing the and over here from the object properties I will be unselecting some of the properties, such as the path and the frame source, because this frame source will vary depending on the environment which you are using. So now again we will drag and drop the capture action, and we will select the same window title, that is BP branded portal, and we will again click on capture object, and then this time we will capture the continue button. And then the action that we will be taking on the object is the click button or the click action. So now again unselect some of the properties, that is path and the HTML frame source. So now over here I will be entering the user ID, that is, and then click on the continue button, and then I will again use the recorder capture action, and then select the window title, and then select the and then click on the capture object in order to capture the object which you want to capture from the application or the web application. So in this case I will be capturing the password field, and then again I will use set text, and then over here select the locker name, that is shopping underscore cart. Again select the credential name, and then select the attribute, that is SRM password, and then uncheck some of the properties, that is path and frame source, and then click on the save button. The final step that needs to be performed is to again select the application and then click on the login button. So click on capture object and then select the logon capture, and then select the logon button to capture. And then the action to take on this object is the click action. Uncheck again the properties, that is path and the frame source, and then click on the save button. So now the next thing that we need to do is to check whether the window appears or not, whether the home window appears or not after login. So over here we will use the if condition, but before using the if condition we will again use wait for window action. So drag and drop the wait for window action, and then in the properties section select the application tab, and then click on the refresh window, and then click on the drop down, and then select the window which you want to work upon, for which you want to wait. So I will be selecting the home window, and then from hyphen till the last I will be replacing that with wildcard character, and the wait time I will give in this case is 20 seconds. Now the next thing that we need to use is to check whether the home window appears or not after waiting for some time. If the window appears, so in this case we will check if window exists. If window exists, and then select the home window, and then over here just put in 5 seconds. So the window exists. We will use a string assignment operation. String assign. So drag and drop the assign action from the string package and assign the value as true, and then store the output in a variable as v login status or vstr login status, and then click on create and select. And in the else part of this, if the window is not existing, so in the else we will copy the string assign action and we will assign the value as false to str login status. So the next step that we have to perform is, if the window exists, that is if the login is successful, so we have to assign the login status as true, and also we have to break the loop. So in order to break the loop, from the loop package drag and drop the break action and then click on the save button. And also the next thing that we have to do is to use try catch block. So if some action fails, the catch block will be able to catch that particular error. So now drag and drop the try catch block inside the loop condition or inside the loop, and put all these actions that we have built up till so far inside the try block. So after putting this inside the try block, so the next thing that you have to perform inside the catch block is use the if condition, and in the if condition property section, from the condition drop down select the number condition, that is if vint increment counter is less than 3, click on save button then, and then again drag and drop the if condition. And in the property section, from the condition drop down select if window exists, and from and then select the application tab, and then select the window which you want to check whether it exists or not. So we will be selecting BP branded portal. If this window exists, we will be closing out this window. So in order to close the window, from the window package drag and drop the close action inside the if condition, and in the property section of this action, that is close action, from the drop down select the required window which you want to close. So in this case I will be selecting BP branded portal. So now after all this, outside the loop you have to check. So again drag and drop the if condition in order to check whether these two conditions are satisfied or not. So drag and drop the if condition, and from the condition drop down select the number condition, that is if vint increment counter is equal to 3, and then click on add condition, and again from the condition drop down select the string condition, that is vstr login status is equals to false. Remove this match case checkbox. If both of these conditions are true, then you just simply print the message box, that is srm login failed even after retrying for 3 attempts, and then click on the save button. So now that we have built all the required steps, we will test whether this retry logic mechanism is working or not. So in the next section we will see by running the bot, that is whether the bot or whether the code that we have built is performing to our expectation or not. So now let us run the bot in order to see that the steps that we have built are performing to our expectation or not. So in order to run the bot, we will click on this run button. So once you click on the run button, the bot agent service will be invoked and all the dependencies and will be downloaded. So over here you can see that the URL is open. So now what we will do is we will close this window, that is the URL window, and see whether the next login happens or not, whether the bot will retry to login again or not. So let us wait for few seconds in order to for the bot to reach that step. So now it is checking whether the counter is less than 3. So the counter is now 2, which is less than 3, and the bot has opened the URL again. Now it will enter the user ID and password and it will login. So the login has happened successfully and the bot has stopped, since the bot has performed its operation successfully. So this is how you can use the retry logic mechanism in your code in order to login to any web application.